One morning, Edward waited at the junction for Toby the tram engine. The two had become good friends since Toby joined the railway not long ago. Edward appreciated having another old engine on the line. Toby arrived looking very cheerful.
Hello, Edward. This is a surprise.
The fat kid Shirley has asked me to come to the junction for a while to give you some help, since you've just arrived.
That's good. I'm still getting used to working in bigger yards. I appreciate your help.
The two were interrupted by the whistle of Thomas the Tank Engine, who huffed angrily into the station, blowing steam everywhere.
I see you two intend to dawdle about all day while I shunt all the trucks.
Edward and Toby chuckled to one another. They knew that Thomas was acting too big for his wheels.
Of course not, Thomas. We wouldn't dream of letting you do all the work.
Good, because these need sorting. I've got to go back to the quarry for more. Thomas was uncoupled and raced out of sight.
Well, Toby sighed, have you ever seen anything like it?
The two engines commenced to shunting the trucks. Edward planned out their approach to the very last detail. Toby was amazed.
It takes great coordination to know where to put which trucks in a big yard like this, said Edward.
You're teaching this old engine new tricks, Toby replied, smiling.
The two were interrupted a second time as Thomas steamed in with another line of trucks to be sorted. Thomas, seeing that Edward and Toby had not finished with the previous set, became furious.
You old timers are so unreliable, he muttered.
Perhaps you would be more useful if you fetched the trucks instead. I'm sure I could have all of these trucks sorted and take my evening train by the time you get back.
Edward and Toby were offended but decided not to reply right away. Edward had an idea to teach Thomas a lesson. He whispered it to Toby.
Very well, Edward replied. We'll change positions. You shunt here since you know better, and we'll fetch the trucks. I can't go all the way to the quarry myself since I'm too heavy, but I'll help after Toby comes down the hill.
Deal, Thomas said defiantly, and so it was arranged. Toby and Edward set off for the quarry. While Thomas set to work on the shunting. It was not long before Thomas realized that he was in over his head. He tried to rush, which made him very frustrated. No sooner had he put one truck in line than he realized that he needed to get to the truck behind it. Soon, Thomas discovered that he was nearly late for his evening passenger train. He scampered away to find Annie and Clarabelle, thinking he could sneak back afterwards to finish shunting. While he was away, Edward and Toby returned. The yard was in an awful mess.
I had a feeling this would happen. Edward smirked.
Toby saw what he meant.
Let's show him what us old engines can do.
The two set to fixing Thomas's spirited but ultimately poor shunting job. They were very methodical about their approach and in short order the trucks were neatly arranged. Thomas, meanwhile, was tearing back up the line after letting off his last passengers. As he approached, he saw how marvelous the yard looked and couldn't believe his eyes.
What kept you?
Asked Toby. Thomas jumped. He tried to speak, but he couldn't, for he was out of breath. The old engine smiled.
I suppose, Edward continued, that as old timers are reliable after all. Wouldn't you agree?